This is a plumbing trade calculation video. In this video, we're going to learn how to find the end-to-end dimension of a pipe. In this diagram here, we have a piece of pipe inserted. In this case, it looks like it's threaded into two 90-degree fittings on either side. So 90-degree on the right fitting, a 90-degree fitting on the right. And what we're trying to find out for this is the actual end-to-end. So the end of the pipe over to the end of the pipe, the piece of pipe, the actual piece of pipe that we have to cut. But more than likely, we'll be given what's called the center-to-center measurement. So the center of the left 90 over to the center of the right 90. And we'll be asked to cut and prepare the piece of pipe that goes between those two 90s. But in order to do that, we must do a quick calculation. So first, we need to know what the FA is. So we need to know what the FA is on the right-hand side and what the FA is on the left-hand, on the left-hand side. These FAs, of course, as we remember from previous videos, FAs are from the center of the fitting to the where the end of the pipe stops in the fitting on either side. If these are two different fittings on either end or two different sizes on either end, we'll need to make sure we get the FA for both sides. Some cases, maybe in this drawing here, they are both 90s on both sides. They're both the same nominal pipe size. So if we have the FA from one side, we will also have the FA for the second side. So either way, we need to find out what the FAs are, either by knowing them or by calculating them. For those who need to know how to learn how to calculate, please see the previous videos on how to find fitting allowance using different fittings. The second thing we need to do is to know the center-to-center measurement. So we have to be given a center from one fitting over to another fitting. We need to be given a center-to-center measurement. From there, we can now move forward to find our end-to-end, our actual cut piece. So our final calculation will be, in order to find our end-to-end, we need to know the center-to-center, and then we subtract the FAs. So in this case, we can subtract the FA total, which just means we've added the two FAs together for either side, and now we're going to subtract it from the center-to-center, or we could write the formula end-to-end equals center-to-center minus, and in brackets, FA1, plus FA2, close brackets, and we're going to subtract that all the way off of the center-to-center dimension. And this is how we find end-to-end, knowing our center-to-center.